Welcome to My Long Island TV. From Manhasset to Montauk, we've traveled our communities to bring you the following events. I'm your host, Waldo Cabrera. My Long Island TV starts now.
We have a stock five game. We have custom item set. Round one, three games, switch them, three games, switch them. Everyone ready to go?
I wanted to revolutionize the way the games were bought, sold, and traded. We wanted to create a safe place for the kids to come, hang out, and be able to socialize, and bring back a very important thing that was been missing from gaming in the last 10 years is social gaming. You know, everything's online, everything's one player with a mic now, so we wanted to bring back that, you know, hit each other when you lose, you know what I mean? We wanted to bring it back to the 90s.
One last time.
All right, I'm staying as Peach.
When we were kids in the 90s, you would either have to go to somebody's house or they'd have to come over to yours to play the multiplayer game, and you have automatic social interaction. My brother and all his buddies, they brought an N64 over with the GoldenEye cartridge and four controllers, and we had a 10 to 15 person rotation going every Friday night.
Who's ready to rumble?
You know, with the tournaments on Friday and Saturday nights, we start at 7 p.m. We allow them to warm up from 6:30. 7 o'clock we start, we kick off, I give out the rules. We play stocks, which are lives. So we play five lives a game, five stock. Whoever has the most points at the end of the 3 hours goes to the semifinals. You get 9-year-olds and 10-year-olds playing this game, and it's just so cool to see.
And from all different eras, they got ColecoVision and everything else, so it's really cool. Sometimes they get to actually play some of my games from my generation, and they still beat me in that too. I mean, when you're playing online and stuff like they do, and you have the headset, it's one thing to have somebody in your ear, but it's different when they're in your face right here, you know?
Well, we're always separated playing different games and stuff, but it's fun to come down and actually play with your friends and family, and beat them most of the time.
My son Matthew is here. It's a safe environment, and he's interacting with other kids, and he's making friends.
And all my crazy video game knowledge, that is pulling to the left. So that's Snick a Shot. It's a very rough experience being a gamer and selling your games for a nickel and that you bought for $60 and trying to get another $60 game, and it's just, you know, the corporations kind of took over. I miss the days where I could walk in and I could talk to a guy who knew what I was talking about. Here you're gonna get the cartridge or the game is actually in your hand. It's clean, it's tested, we're gonna warranty it for you. So at least you have, you know, peace of mind that if it doesn't work, you can come back.
Most of the old games you pick up and within 10 seconds you know what you gotta do. The new games, it could take you an hour to learn all the combinations, and for some people, you know, some people they go to work all day, they're, you know, they're tired, they wanna come home. They just wanna kinda relax, pick some up, play for a little bit, and you know, then do whatever they gotta do. But a lot of people probably who grew up with gaming still play them, but there's something about the old stuff. They got jobs now, they got the interest, they have kids of their own, they wanna show their kids, hey, like, look, this is how it used to be. So that is what spawned this entire wave of retro mania.
Put a whole brand new housing in there, new top stick, new bottom stick, all brand new. Yeah, it's really funny because you get a dad at like 45, 50 years old, he'll be bringing in his 10-year-old, and the 10-year-old is driving him to come in here, and dad comes in here and is like, whoa, you have all my stuff too. Yeah, Atari 800, the Commodore 64, the two Pong paddles, original Commodore 64 drives, the ColecoVisions, Intellivisions, Odysseys. They don't sell as much because it's more nostalgic, but around Christmas, you always get that wife comes in and says, oh, my husband had this growing up and I have to have it again. So, you know, they buy an Atari original because that's what they grew up with in, you know, in 78. So it's very cool. Will retro games go dead? I don't know. You try to parallel it to something that has happened in history, like comic books or you know, baseball cards. And it has a lot of parallels, but nothing has ever been playable.